Shalom, this is Pastor Ocean Hamandish of Christian Walk Ministries. I want to welcome you all, our viewers, and also welcome our church members who are in different places. I want to greet those in Zimbabwe who are following us in Zimbabwe. I just want also to greet those in Durban. I want to greet those in Mozambique. I also want to greet those who are with us here where I'm currently residing, a building and assembly. Today I'm coming to you because I just want to encourage you with a short message, with a scripture that God also put in my spirit. Remember, we are moving with the theme "Thy will be done," and we are going to seek God in that direction, in that context. But as we are embarking in prayer and fasting, I know it's something that people may debate, but we are not here to debate anything, because it depends with conviction and what God has said concerning to individual or to churches, particularly to what God will assign each and every person to do, because we may have different purposes and we may have different agendas in how we should conduct fasting. So today I'm not discussing the nitty-gritties of fasting, but I'm just here to encourage us, to encourage those who are following us, since I've announced and posted that we are embarking on a five-day prayer and fasting. This is our norm as a church, that before we step into a new year, we normally take a retreat so that we seek the mind of God concerning the following year. And this is the same thing that we are doing this 2021 as we look into 2022. But we are doing it in the context of the theme, as God was speaking to me, that we don't just want to present our needs, we don't just want to present our plans, as much as we are going to do that, as much as I know people will be doing that, but we also want to know the mind of God. I know some of you, you may agree with me, that as much as people are saying we are seeking God's will, but some, most of the time, when the time is like this, when the year is about to end or we are beginning the year, our prayers and fasting normally they will be focusing on what we want God to do, what we want to see, which is not a problem, because also God gave that provision through the word of God that we may present our petition. But sometimes we look and blindly to extend that we may not even give God room to say what is the will of God, because we go before him with our plans. But now this year, we just want to empty ourselves and say, Lord, we need to hear from you. For those who have their plans, I'm not saying shelve your plans. I'm not saying do not continue. Here we are not saying we need to be robots who never pursue the dreams and the vision that we have. But in our pursuing whatever we desire, we need to include God, we need to involve God to guide us and to lead us in the right way. So this is where I am, so that we'll get results. We'll know that once we start to do something, once you embark in doing something, you believe and you know that God is behind whatever you are doing. So we are seeking God's way, God's will in what we are desiring, at the same time emptying ourselves so that we'll hear God, so that God maybe will approve or may direct us in how we should conduct or how we should maybe implement those plans. This is where I'm coming from. So I want to go to the scripture that God have impressed in my spirit, which is in line with what I was sharing all along in the book of Ezra. The book of Ezra is a book that is also similar with Nehemiah. The events surrounding the book of Ezra that are involving in rebuilding the temple, relocating people, they were also restructured and resettled and so forth. But we are not going into those details, because I just want to take a scripture that will also encourage us to know that if we seek God's way in every way, for these people, they seek God so that God will guide them. So spiritually speaking, we can implement this, although these people were also seeking this, yes, using spiritual means, but they were seeking also the guidance and the protection on the physical note. So let's go to Ezra chapter 8 from verse 21. The Bible says, "Then I proclaimed a fast there at the river Ahava, that we might humble ourselves before God, to seek from him the right way for us and our little ones and all our possessions. For I was ashamed to request of the king an escort of soldiers and horsemen to help us against the enemy on the road, because we had spoken to the king, saying, 'The hand of our God is upon all those who seek him, but his power and his wrath are against all those who forsake him.' So we fasted and entreated for our God for this, and he answered our prayer." So this is what Ezra and his group and those who were with him did. They fasted, they went before the Lord, they humbled themselves, that as they were in transition, instead of asking the king to escort them so that they can be protected by soldiers and with the physical maybe means of protection, and also escorted until they reached to the place they wanted to reach, they asked God. They said, "Our God is going to be with us." So they fasted, asking God to guide them and to lead them in the right way. The other version said, "In a straight way," and "in the straight path," and "the right way." So as they did that, the Bible says God heard them and he granted them what they asked for, which means God protected them. God was with them as they were in transit, and God protected them with their little ones, their possession. They refused to use the physical means, the military, and they believed that even if they had the military or the soldiers from the king, they were not protected enough, because anything can happen if God is not there. So they decided to say, "Let's humble ourselves before God. We know God has got army, a battalion of army that cannot be seen with naked eyes, and that will protect them until they reach their destiny." So taking from this scripture, and we want to apply it in the manner that we are conducting our fasting, we are saying we need God to lead us in the right way. These were seeking the right way, protection, as they move physically. But now we are taking it a spiritual, that whatever is going to be manifested in 2022, as we walk our way, as we do our things, as we work, as we project our businesses, or as we be preaching the word of God as a church, we need God to lead us in the right way. Our protection and our covering and the direction that we need is not a physical thing that we are desiring. You must note that they were not just praying that God will escort them spiritually, but they also asked God to guide them in the right path, which means whatever destiny they wanted to reach and whatever settlement that they wanted to be, or the environment or territory that they were going to settle as they were in this transition, they were supposed to be guided by God the right way. Otherwise, they were going to be lost and end up maybe moving around and be like the children of Israel who wandered for 40 years. This is something that can happen to anyone, to a family, to individual, or to a church. We end up wandering for many years without results. And we are saying we want God to guide us so that we can reach precisely to where we can actually receive or see the hand of God and the results. So as we'll be praying, remember that we are seeking God's will to happen in your life, in your family, in your business, in your church, in your plans, and everything that you are going to do. Seek the right way, seek the will of God, seek the guidance of God in how you are going to conduct whatever you are going to do. Your plans, yes, you may plan, for God did not stop us to plan, but we need to pray that God will lead us in the right way as we'll be planning, as we'll be desiring to see these plans coming to fruition, so that we'll take the right path. So let me read one scripture that I want to close with, as I promise that I want to make this encouragement, very short. Let's go to Isaiah chapter 30 from verse 21. This is another scripture, again, where God was speaking. It was something that he was speaking and encouraging his people, or it was a word that was concerning for that particular group of people, as Isaiah was prophesying. But we can still see and learn that there's also the right path, there's also the right way. The Bible says in Isaiah chapter 30, your ears shall hear the word behind you saying, this is the way, walk in it, whenever you turn to the right hand or whenever you turn to the left. So if you read the context of the scripture, God was speaking about the teachers whom God was going to give his people, and said, yet your teachers will not be moved into a corner anymore, but your eyes shall see your teachers and your ears shall hear a word saying, this is the way, walk in it, which means God was going to send the direction through probably his servants or through his prophetic message, whatever means, to speak to his people as direction. That was going to be up to him, or that is going to be at the same time up to him, as we seek also God to say, we need to hear the voice of God, the direction of God, and the voice of God telling us that this is the way we should take, this is the way that we should implement things, this is the way which we must work out the things, and this is what we are going to focus on in 2022. So as we humble ourselves, it's not just about afflicting our body. We need to put our spirit and mind together and sincerely look unto God and say, Lord, you are the leader. You are the captain of our life. Lead us, guide us in 2022. Show us the things that we must do. And as we do that, you also show us the things that we must avoid and the things that should come. And prophetically, we may tap into the next 12 months and understand what will come. You are going to hear that the voice saying, this is the way you should walk, this is the way you should take. I just want maybe to say, for some of us who drive, you understand that if you are driving in a new location, here I'm living in a nation where you cannot guess your location, especially if you are in big cities, you need to put a GPS. And that GPS will be telling you that turn right, turn left until you reach your destiny. Even if you don't know that the place, even if it's your first time, if you follow that GPS, you'll be at the exact place or within the vicinity of the area that the GPS will be directing you. And this the GPS normally the drivers use in order to reach where they want to reach. So this time around, we are asking God to guide us with his GPS. And where they say global position system, which is GPS, we are now saying God's positioning system. So God is the one who position us, guiding us to say, turn right, turn left. This is the way you should walk. So we are praying as we are seeking God's way to say, God, this is, Lord, us, we need you to guide us with your own GPS, the God position system concerning 2022, concerning the next 5-20 years that will come, but it will start as we humble ourselves to pray. So brethren, let's not take this lightly. Depend, we may differ in how we see prayer and fasting, depend with the conviction, depend with the vision, with how God speaks to people. But as a church, as a group that was called for a specific ministry, this is what we are going to do. And we are encouraging even our friends and those who have indicated that they are going to be part of this prayer and fasting. You are all welcome, because it is for your benefit spiritually, not necessarily as a church and ministry. Because myself, I believe that beyond the territory of my own assignment in the church of the people that I'm leading, I believe that I must also contribute to the body of Christ to a certain extent. So when I minister, I trust that one or two people may also be helped with what we'll be sharing. So I'm encouraging you, for those who indicated their willingness to join us, even if they are not part of Christian Work Ministries. God bless you. I'm trusting God that His will is going to be done. His will is going to take place in your life, and God is going to guide you so that you can have fruits for 2022. Shalom. Remain under God's covering. May God guide you.